tristes a mí cuando nadie me vio. Me amaste a mí cuando nadie me vio. Me diste a mí cuando nadie me vio. Me amaste a mí cuando nadie me
message. Amen. Amen. Well, I'm not going to be preaching this morning. We have a special guest this morning that will be bringing the word of God. Could you please stand in honor Pastor Carmen Bustamante? She's going to be bringing the word of God. My wife, my bride, my love, and over here on the bottom. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah, I'll bring it. That is, thanks guys, I appreciate it. I know it's a little heavy in it, brother. Okay, I'll bring it to you right now.
Y'all may sit down. It's just amazing to see everybody here, just rejoicing, amen, celebrating the goodness of God. This is all God's goodness, that we get to see each other. Thank you, brother. And I'm going to try my best to do what I can do here, because, you know, I fully surrender to the Holy Spirit when I worship, and He takes over. So if you're not sure what that means, or you want to know more about it, read Acts 2. Okay, go read Acts, because that's when the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, that's where it talks about how the Helper. And let me tell you that, you know, people were accused of being drunk with wine or just, you know, some other spirits. But praise God, I got His Spirit, okay? This is all Holy Spirit, and I just want to encourage you, read more about it, just in case you're not familiar. I look crazy up here, because I am filled. before we start, well, you know what? I want to honor the single moms. If you're a single mom, I want you to stand up. Because I want to honor you. Every single mom. There's only three. Well, praise God, there's only three. And I just want to give you, it's not the word of God in Isaiah 53 says that your husband is the maker, the God of hosts. He is your faithful husband. He is the one that you rely on. He's the one that's going to protect you. He's the one that's going to cover you. Because, you know, as a single parent, you're both. You're the dad and the mom. And you have to be the protector and the nourisher. And that's a lot of work. So I encourage you, read Isaiah 53. He is faithful husband that will never leave you, that will never let you down. He will supply everything that you need, and he will never be late or too early. He's always on time. He will give you strength. So rely on your faithful husband, the maker of heaven and earth. Amen. I love you, ladies. My heart goes out to all of y'all. Amen. Before we start, I want you to watch this video. And hopefully it will bless you. Do y'all got the video ready? All right. Give me 4 minutes and watch this video. Whoa. Okay. Turn the lights off.
Chemistry lab.
No, you did not.
It's a long story.
Okay.
How was choir?
It was good.
Moms have it so easy. I mean, their lives are fun, simple, and so rewarding. Sometimes I wish, instead of being the dad, I wish I was the mom. Another day of pedicures, reading my magazines, and making myself beautiful. This is the life.
Mom? Mom, tell him to stop copying me.
Mom, tell him to stop copying me.
I'm not kidding. Mom, do something.
Mom, there's something.
Are you serious? Mom, are you serious? Why did I ever ask you to help me? I should have known you couldn't fix my hair. I look like a freak. Look at me.
Hey, Mom. Look at this. Look at me. Come on, Mom. Look at me. Watch this, Mom. Come on. Look at this. Watch this. Mom, look at me. Come on, Mom. Look at me. Come on, Mom. Look at me. Come on.
Report due tomorrow, and I haven't read any of this.
Mom, if you don't help me, I'm gonna fail school and be a loser forever.
You don't expect me to read this all by myself, do you? You don't expect me to eat this, do you?
Seriously, Mom, what is this?
Mom, I'm not gonna eat this.
Dad, can we just go out to eat, please?
Hey, kids, be nice to your mother.
If I eat this, I'm gonna throw up.
Mom, I said I'm gonna throw up.
Mom, I think I'm gonna be sick too.
You're amazing.
No, seriously. I don't know how you do it. I'm at a loss for words. Kids, come here. Get in here. Hug your mother. Tell her you love her. We're in the presence of greatness.
Dad.
Not now. Dad's on a roll. This is God's greatest creation, kids.
You're smushing my face.
Sorry. And I'm sorry. Because I don't say thank you enough. I mean, the truth is, I don't deserve you. We
don't deserve you. And one day is not enough to honor you. We should honor you every day. But how do we say thank you to the woman that means the world to us? I know. We're going to go right now and get you that vacuum cleaner you've had your eye on. Don't speak. This time, we're going name brand, baby. Come on, kids. Let's go make your mom's dreams come true.
Amen. Did y'all enjoy it? I don't want a vacuum. I don't want a new vacuum. I like to shop, so a shopping spree would be nice. Okay, well, I don't know if y'all know this, but I was curious about the history of when do we start celebrating Mother's Day? Does anybody know? No? Well, I didn't know till this week. Well, okay, I'm going to have to sit down. Hold on. Okay, I was looking it up, and 150 years ago, there was this lady called Anna Jarvis. Does anybody know Anna Jarvis? Never read about her? Shame on you, no. Well, anyways, she organized a day to raise awareness of poor health conditions in her community, something she thought mothers believed in doing, right? So she called it Mother's Work Day. And she organized that, you know, 150 years ago. Then she passed away, and her daughter, that was also her name, Anna, she wanted to honor all that her mother did. So Anna heard about her mother say that one day she hoped someone would make a special day just for mothers. So back then we didn't celebrate, 150 years ago, we didn't celebrate Mother's Day. And so Anna worked very hard and even talked to presidents and leaders to try to create something special just to honor them. By 1914, Woodrow Wilson signed a bill saying it's a National Mother's Day holiday. So 1914, that's when it was established, and it was a bill, a national holiday for the U.S. And then I was curious about, does other countries celebrate Mother's Day? Some of them do, especially the Hispanic ones, and they celebrate Mexico, Salvador, and Honduras. They celebrate May the 10th. So their Mother's Day is in Tuesday, next Tuesday, this Tuesday coming up. And there's other countries, of course, that celebrate the second Sunday of May. So all around the world, we are celebrating mothers because they are special. All of y'all are special. All of y'all are special. Without my mother, I mean, where would we be? Praise God. And it was God that ordained that. Amen. So glory to God. So I just want to give you a little history, you know, on how it all became about in the United States. 150 years ago, that's when we started celebrating Mother's Day. Before it was Mother's Work Day. But praise God, just want to give you that little nugget just in case, you know, because pastors say we can't just, you know, do tradition things, right? Look it up. What does it mean? You know, what's the history? But there's always a history about something. Amen? Yeah. So let's not just celebrate just because it's, you know, we've been doing it for the last 20, 50 years. Amen. Glory to God. And another thing I want to talk to you. this Mother's Day, I want to talk to you about honor. Because, you know, yes, you know, we honor our mothers on Mother's Day, and you know, it should be every day. It should be every day that we honor our parents, you know, not just Mother's Day, but our parents, our leaders, each other. Because, you know, I was looking it up in the Word, and I was just seeing how God ordained us to honor each other. You know, Pastor was telling me a while back that he says God wants us to honor each other. That's why he kept telling us in the Word, honor your parents, honor your siblings, honor each other. God, he kept saying it so many times that, you know, that we need to take it seriously. That word honor is a five-letter word, but it's so powerful to bless others and to save marriage, because God says, honor your wife, honor your husband. Amen? And that's in the Word, and if you want to test my spirit, go ahead. It's in the... Well, let me see, where's it at? No, I found an awesome scripture. It's in Romans, somewhere in Romans. But that five-letter word is so powerful, and I want to, you know, I want to break it down, and I want to give you scriptures how it is so important. It's very important because God's been talking about it since the Exodus of Egypt. Remember Egypt? I mean, remember the Israelites when they came out of Egypt? That's when he gave Moses the law. And now I'm going to tell you about, you know, the law, the Ten Commandments. Did you ever ask and think, why did God give these rules? Because it was already happening. There were people out of order. You know, they got corrupted in Egypt. They got so messed up with their religion, with their lifestyle, that they brought it out. You know, they brought it. So that's why God gave the commandments to Moses. All that stuff that said, thou shalt not, thou shalt not, thou shalt not, was happening. So he's like, I'm giving you order. So that word honor is part of the order that God ordained for the family.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. And remember, God, that word order can bless somebody and can save a marriage.
Amen.
Amen. When we start honoring each other, you know, and that word honor, do we all know what that mean? Y'all can, I like to, you know, talk to y'all, I can talk back to me. Interact. That word honors esteem, value, respect. It's worth, it's order. I, you know, I just recently learned that that word honor is order. It means order.
Amen.
It's another word for honor. Because when me and my husband start honoring each other at home, it brings order to the house. And when it brings order, then it's going to trickle down to the kids, and the kids are going to start seeing it. Of course, they're going to act silly and crazy every now and then, but, you know, they'll see the honor established in the home. Amen? And it will bless, it will produce fruit.
Yes,
it will. So, let me see, before I get ahead of myself. I want to read to you Romans 13:7. And if you have your Bible, go ahead and look it up. I'll read you the whole scriptures, but what I'm going to focus on is on the last paragraph here. It says, render to all men their dues. Pay taxes to whom taxes are due. Revenue to whom revenue is due. And then right here, this is my nugget right here. Respect to whom respect is due, and honor to whom honor is due. And that's why we honor each other, and that's why we honor our parents. We honor Mother's Day today, because this is a commandment. This is an ordained day that God had planned already for us. This is something that he wants us to take serious. We take it very lightly, and, you know, I myself too, I'm guilty of that word honor. If God's continued to say it in his word, you know, He brought it out in Deuteronomy. That was the first time you heard, well, it's in the word that says, honor your parents. Because that's a promise when you do that.
Yes.
And that promise is that you're going to live well.
Yes.
Long life, it will satisfy you. And a lot of times, we disrespect, we dishonor. And we see our lives in chaos and in out of order. Why? There's no honor. There's no honor. When we start honoring, I mean, this is a commandment that God said that has a promise. Because the other commandments, the promise is death. All the other commandments is you're going to die. You're going to be stoned. So this is the only commandment that God said, you're going to have a fruitful life.
Amen.
Amen? So today, this is what I want you to get. Esteem that word, honor. Keep it in your home, because it starts with the home. It doesn't start at church. It doesn't start at school. It doesn't start at your work job. It starts at home.
Yes.
Whatever you do starts at home, and then it will come out to the other places you go to. So when we start using that word in perspective, when we start walking out that word, then we're going to see a manifestation of God's order, God's blessing.
Wow.
Because that's what his word says. That's not what I'm saying. That's a revelation he's given me through his word. Amen?
He's very
so powerful. You can bless somebody and you can save a marriage.
Amen.
By honoring each other. Amen? If I didn't honor my husband, oh my God. If we didn't practice that. And let me tell you, we fall short. You know, there's times where we fall short, but we come to repentance. Like, I apologize for, you know, being out of you know, we come to each other. But the more we practice it, the more it becomes natural, and the more it becomes real in our lives. And then the more we get to enjoy each other's marriage. When there's no honor, there's no peace. There's no reverence, no respect for each other. Amen. And this is God's word, and God wants us to hold that very valuable in our lives, because it has so much power, so much blessings, and we're missing out. Amen.
Yeah.
And this is a Mother's Day message. It's not just for husbands and wives, but you know, when we honor our parents, it is a joy. And if you have a hard time honoring your parents, you have some forgiveness, you know, unforgiveness. I'm sorry to say that. There's some offense. And, you know, I know, because I've done it. There was times where I couldn't honor my parents. I couldn't honor them the way, you know, God's word says, or God, or, you know, the way I should, because there was some hurt. It's like, you did this to me, so I'm going to choose not to honor you. You know, I'm going to hold back my love because you did this or you did that, or you weren't there for me. You know, but I'll explain that later on. I'm getting ahead of myself, but I want to dig into this word honor, because it goes beyond. It's powerful. It's powerful. It can save your marriage, and it can bless beyond what you can think. Amen?
Amen.
So that word honor, and another thing that the Lord was showing me about honoring is that honoring is spiritual. You want to be spiritual? Everybody in here wants to be spiritual, right? Honor each other. Not just your, you know, of course your parents, but honor your kids, honor your husband. Start doing that. I challenge you to start doing that for a week and see the blessings that come out of it, because that's what the word of God says. There's blessing. Yeah. Amen?
Amen?
And, you know, okay, let's go to Romans 12:10, because I want to show you in the word that God, he's exalting this word. You know, in Romans 10:12 says, showing to one another honor. Is it up there? Oh. Showing to one another honor. He's commanding it. He keeps telling us. It started in Deuteronomy. I'm sorry, in Exodus 20. That's Exodus 20. I'll give you the scripture. Exodus 20:12, where it says, regard your father and your mother. Your days may be long in the land of the Lord, in the land the Lord your God gives you. And then I got the Amplified. The Amplified says, regard, treat with honor, due obedience and courtesy your father and mother, that your days may be long in the land the Lord your God gives you. Now you may say, that's in the Old Testament. We don't live by that. Not true. Every word in here from page 1 to page the last page, it's all God's breath. So every word is true. Every little dot, every little thing that is in here, it's true. So, and then I was going to show you, and then in Leviticus, it keeps talking about that commandment. And then Jesus was telling everybody, in Matthew 5:4, it says, for God commanded, honor your father, your mother, and he who curses or reviles or speak evil or abuse or treat improperly his father and mother, let him surely come to his end by death. Back then, you die. Say something against, you know, against your mom. You will die. I mean, drop dead. That was the penalty. Because it was too much of that. And, you know, that was chaos. Who wants chaos? No order, no law. So that's why, you know, God was putting this commandment. But praise God for the New Testament. We got grace. You know, we don't drop dead if we disrespect our parents, but you know what? You're not going to go far.
Yeah. Come on. Yeah.
You're going to be limited to what you can do, because there's a promise. And when we disobey against the word, When we go against what it says, even if you don't know it, there's a blockage. There's a blockage, you know, and that's why it's so awesome and vital to know your word, not only to know it, but walk the word, do what it says. Because the only difference between us and the spirit, because those demons, they know the word more than we do. They know every little loophole, everything. But the only difference is that we walk the word. We're doers of the word. Yeah. Amen?
Yeah.
And we are the kingdom of light. That's another one. Learning something today. I love y'all. It is an honor to be here this morning to bring the word. This is my first Sunday ever. And, you know, it's awesome. And it's at the same time, it's like, wow, I can't believe I'm doing this on a Sunday. Because I like to teach on Wednesdays. And on Wednesdays, it's more like, you know, Bible study. So I invite you to come Wednesday nights. And it's more, you know, it's a little different. But anyways, moving along here. So Matthew 5:14, Jesus was telling, you know, the disciples and everybody about obeying. So if Jesus is telling, when Jesus speaks in the word, that means it still stands. Amen? And then in Ephesians 6, Paul was telling the Ephesians, children, I'm going to read it to you. This is the Amplified Version. Children, obey your parents in the Lord as his representative, for this is just and right. Honor, esteem, value as precious. Your father and your mother, this is the first commandment with promise. This is the only commandment with a promise. Amen? The only one. The other ones, are they bring death. And like I told you, you know, you can't go far. If you are walking in disobedience, and if, you know, especially the young ones that are still at home, you know, it is for your own good, your own benefit, your own benefit, because you're working against yourself. You're not going to go far. You can't. There, God said, you know, when you don't do it, there's death. You don't die spiritually, but you're not going to grow. There will be no life. Amen. So listen, young kids, it is for your own benefit, whether you feel like it or you don't like how they tell you or you don't like how they do it, do it. It's for your own benefit, because you won't go far in life. And I'll testify to that in a little bit. You can't. It's God's word, and you can't go against God's word. Amen? So submit, kids. Submit to God's word. Submit to what he's telling you here, because there's blessings and there's promises, and you're missing out. You're the one missing out on the blessings and the promises. Amen?
Amen.
No pointing fingers. Okay. Now, I wanted you to see that in the word, how God, you know, talks about honoring each other and how, you know, he wants us to honor each other. You know, the glory belongs to him. He commands us to honor each other. You know, that's not taking God's glory. So this is why we celebrate Mother's Day. And of course, every other holiday, Father's Day and all that. But honor each other. It's a blessing. So that word glory, I just want to give you a little nugget. That word glory means fame. Pastor always said that, you know, if you want to go deeper in the Word of God, look it up in the Greek. So I looked it up, glory, and it means it's weighty and it's fame. So when me and him are honoring each other, we are bringing glory to God. We're not taking glory from God. We're giving glory to him. Our marriage is glorifying him. We're bringing him, God, fame. Amen? Because you and I are known by our fruits, not by how many times you come to church. Because, you know, I did that for many years. I went to church plenty of times just to look good, but there was no fruit in here. There was no fruit in my life. But when we start, you know, activating the word, walking the word, and it took a lot of practice because, you know, we weren't used to walking out the word. We weren't used to doing the opposite of what we, you know, what was right. Amen? Flesh was just fighting us. It's like, no, this is my way. You know, we've been doing it for like 20-something years. Why you want to stop now? You know, flesh is going to cry. Flesh is just going to just scream every day. What are you doing? Go against it. Because this flesh, you know, yes, it is dead, But God says, you know, let me read it to you. Romans, I think it's 12:2. Is it Romans 12:2 or 12? Well, let me find it. I'm going to just share that little nugget with you. Okay, it says, it's one. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice. Yes, your body is dead to sin, but it is still alive. Amen. It is still alive because God gave you this new man, this new body now, that you have to learn how to operate with the Spirit of God. So it's, because he doesn't want anything dead. If it's dead, it's no use to him. You know, back then when they did sacrifices, God did not want anything dead or anything lame or anything sick. Amen? Amen. So we bring this body as a living sacrifice unto God. And do you know what a sacrifice is? That means it hurts, right? Uh-huh. So bring it to God. Because, I mean, even if it hurts, because it's, you know, it's that's what he wants. And when you do it, man, blessings. Amen. Okay, well, let's see what else I got here. So we all understand why it's important to honor, right? And I'm going to share with you one more scripture in 2 Timothy. Oh, I already got it here. 2 Timothy 3, it says, but understand this, that in the last days will come great stress and trouble. I'm reading the Amplified, so I don't know. Okay, they're not putting it up there. Oh, they are. Okay, it says, for people will be lovers of birth, but praise God I didn't. Not to scare you, not to put any fear in you. But I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know what to expect when he came out. And it was something that I had to learn. You know, I had to learn how to be a mother. And like I told you, me and my mom didn't have a good relationship in the beginning. So the only thing I got from her is food. So I knew if I just feed my son, he'll be good. So that's all I did with Eddie most of the time, just feed him. Feed him. And he loves to eat too, right? You know, I didn't, you know, because I was thinking about this, you know. And of course she, you know, showed me other stuff too, how to cook. And I was cooking by the age of 6, you know. I like to eat and nobody was home to cook for me sometimes. So I had to learn how to cook early. And so, you know, she taught me all that and, you know, clean up and stuff I didn't like to do, you know, when you're young. So later on in life, you know, we struggled. Our relationship struggled. And it was not till, let me see. Well, let me back it up. You know, I wasn't, you know, you're 16, you really don't know, you don't have wisdom, you don't have understanding of how to raise a child. You know, my husband, he was in jail for 2 years, so I was taking him everywhere, back and forth. I was a wild child, you know, most of you know I was a wild child, amen. But God, you know, when my husband came out, you know, he got saved and he that's where he found God, in jail. But when he came out in jail, you know, it took us a couple of years to get, you know, right with God. We started going to Lakewood after that. And that's where it started for me to change my ways as a mother, because I wasn't a good mother. I was very selfish, you know. I didn't know how to be a mom, like a real mom, you know. I was just a mom, just, you know. Of course, I nurtured my child. I did what I could. I fed him a lot. I gave him candy a lot, you know. That was a good mom to me. I didn't have a good understanding of being a mom, you know, the best mom. So when I started going to church, that's when I started to learn about, you know, being the mom that I need to be. Being that spiritual mom, being that nurturing mom, you know. And I love my kids. You know, when you have kids, you just have this love for them that, you know, you see beyond their flaws. You see beyond the, of course, it hurts when they do something against you, you know. It's like they just stabbed you, like you just got stabbed in the heart. But praise God for grace, right? Amen. You know, but so I learned how to, you know, change my ways, my habits of being a mom. And so being a mom wasn't easy for me from, you know, 1994 till maybe 2004. It was, wow. 10 years later. Yeah, that's 10 years later. So little by little, you know, those old ways were falling off. You know, those old patterns of being a bad mom. And then I had other people to remind me, you were a bad mom. I'm just going to tell on my sister, because she's very honest with me, you know. And my sister's like, you're a bad mom. I was like, I know, you know. I didn't take it to heart because I already knew, you know, you're right. But I love her because she tells me the truth. So anybody tells you the truth, high five. Give them high five. We need somebody to tell us the truth, okay? Amen. So, you know, moving along, I hope I'm not boring you with my story. Oh, it's almost time. Okay. Okay.
Tell us more.
So, you know, when I started going at Lakewood and God really did something in my heart, he circumcised my heart. I mean, a lot of stuff happened. And, you know, but I yielded. You got to yield to God. Don't just come to church and say, okay, I did my duties. Yield your heart to him. Yes. Come with an open heart. Don't worry about who's going to look at you if you're like your makeup is all smeared, mocos are coming out. Let it all go. I mean, you know, I just had an awesome encounter with God, you know. It's me and him time when I come to, you know, to the altar with him. I just love it. So don't be ashamed. Don't be embarrassed. Come to the altar when you're worshiping and just say, Lord, you know, I'm opening my heart to you because, you know, I need this healing. I need this love. Amen. Don't be ashamed, because you will have an encounter with God, with his love. And see, that's what changed my heart towards my mom. You know, I had an encounter with his love, and his love started healing my heart, where all the hurt, all the offenses that my mom did started going. They started leaving. You know, of course, I had to make a choice, because God's not going to release or take anything from you until you say, okay, here it is. And stop taking it back. We need to stop taking things back. When once we release, it's gone. And just remind that devil, I let it go. I let that hurt go, that offense go, I let it go. Amen. So, you know, when I started going to Lakewood, that's where the healing started for me. And I started seeing my mom differently. You know, yes, she was still rough. Yes, she was telling me things, you know, oh, you look fat, or, you know, what's wrong with you? Do this and do that. You know, my mom is a powerful caloric woman. She's powerful. Amen? She gets things done. Amen? She's a hard worker. I love that about her. So, you know, that's one thing that the Lord started showing me. Look at her attributes, her good things, you know, her good qualities. She fed you all the time. Amen? She protected me. Yes. I was never like fear, you know. Amen. So that's something that I thank her for. God started healing my heart. I started honoring my mom. And now our relationship, it's amazing. I love her. You know, I'm there for her when I can. You know, I'm not there 24/7. And there's times where she still gets mad at me, you know. And she still wants to hurt me. So now I have to run. But, you know, I still choose to honor her because, you know, years ago, I was listening to Charles Stanley's teaching where it says, he was teaching about honoring your father and your mother. And, you know, I was still having a hard time letting go of certain things. And he said, you know, God didn't say only honor them if they were good to you. It's not in the scripture. Did you see it in Matthew 15? It didn't say only honor if they're good to you. He just said honor. So that broke things inside of me, where it's like, you know, regardless of what they did or what they said or what happened, I'm going to honor them, and I'm going to do the best that I can to help them, you know, to live a peaceful life, because, you know, they're mature and they need help now, you know. They're not young like they used to. They can't work hard like they used to. My mom's a hard worker, and I love her. You know, she's my idol. I'm still amazed that she still gets up early in the morning at 3 o'clock in the morning, you know, cleaning. And that's what she used to do when I was little. That's why I couldn't stand it, you know. We were the opposite. I used to love to sleep in, and she would get at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. Okay, it's time to clean up. Saturday mornings, you know, you just came from school. And it's like, it's time to clean up. go wash all the clothes, everything, you know. And we lived in apartments, so it was hard to drag all the clothes down from upstairs, me and my sister, because it was always me and my sister. I was her helper, and my sister did a lot of the hard work. I really didn't do a lot of the work, but still, you know, it was, so that's one thing I couldn't, like, oh, just leave me alone. But, you know, praise God, because, you know, now I remember all the stuff that she made me did, you know, it pays off. It pays off. And, but, you know, today, before you leave today, I just want you to check your heart. And just release anything that is stopping you from going beyond, above and beyond, for not just your mother, but for each other, for your kids, for your husband, your brother, somebody. There's somebody there that you have a hard time honoring. And it's because of offense and hurt, past hurt. And these are the things that block us from moving forward. You cannot go far. The Word of God says that you can't go far. And if you want to go further than what you are right now, do it. But, you know, I want you to just check your heart, and I want you to just close your eyes and just say, I release any offense that I have towards my mother, towards my father, towards anybody. Any offense, any hurt, any unforgiveness, I release it. And I choose to love unconditionally. Whether they say I'm sorry or whether they do, I choose today to release them from my heart, from my soul, in Jesus' name. I just want to thank you for hearing me out today. I just gave you a little bit of my testimony, and that's just a little part, and we ran out of time. So next year, part two. But I love you, and happy Mother's Day.
You guys move this pulpit real quick, and I want to do something. I want to close this meeting with honoring the mothers again. So if you're a mom, can you come up here? And we just want to pray over these mothers, because, you know, it's not easy being a mom. We know that. We just saw the video, the skit guys, right? They just showed us. So if you're a mother, just please come up here. And we're just, as the men of the house, amen, and the children of the house, we are going to pray for our women, our first ladies, our you know, all of these moms, amen. Can you move forward a little bit, because there's still some more, amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on up here, Juanita. Come on, you're a mother. That's all right. Put it on pause. It's all good. We want all of our moms up here. And we just love you guys. We love y'all so much. And we just thank God for y'all. There are not words in the our human vocabulary to express of what y'all mean to us. And to, you know, the thing about a mom is that she doesn't only just nurture her own, she nurtures all of those kids around her. How many of you are mothers in the children's church, and how many of you mothers in your neighborhood? You know, I know the effects of a mom, and I thank God that He's given me my mom for all my years. You know, I never lacked love. I never lacked a belt either. Come on now. She says, I hit you because I love you. I was wondered, I was a favorite child. Amen. Amen. It's good to be disciplined, because when you're disciplined, means that you're loved. If you don't get disciplined, the Bible says you're not loved. So, you know, I want you to do something. I want all the men of God, to stretch your hands out towards these mothers. And with all you moms, I just want you to just bow your heads and close your eyes. I just want you to receive today. Receive this word of blessing. Father God, I pray a blessing over these women. I pray a blessing over these mothers, Father, that they love without conditions. They love without any strings attached, Father. They've given their all to their children. They've given their all to the people around them, Father God. And Father, I just pray, Father, that you would just pour into them the strength and you just continue to deposit more love so that for them to give out, Lord. And I just pray, Father, for all the hurts and the pains in their lives, Father God, that you would just heal every wound today. Every wound that was caused by their childhood, every wound that was caused by another person, every wound that it was caused even by their children or by their husbands, Lord. I pray, Father, that you would heal those wounds in their lives, Lord. Father, I pray for just a restoration, that they would just be able to receive from you today, Father. And then as they walk out of this place, Father, as they open when they just walk out and they can continue to smile, Lord. They can still laugh, Lord. They can still love, and they won't allow the hurts in their lives to determine how much they can love, Father, but they will love like you unconditionally. Today, Father, I pray right now for a fresh anointing on them. A fresh anointing, Lord. A fresh anointing, Lord. That you may fill them up, that they may overflow, Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord, for this day. We honor these women by honoring you, Lord. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. And we give you all the praise. In Jesus' name. Amen. I want you to just say right now, say, I receive my healing. I receive my strength comes from you. And Lord Jesus, I let go of any offense, any hurts, any pains, and I put on the garment of love. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Well, we love you. We thank you. We honor you. And I just want you to have a blessed Mother's Day. Amen. Now, real quick, do we have some people in the back that are going to be giving out the gifts? Okay, we're going to have two people in that door and one person at that door. And we just want to tell you, happy Mother's Day. Have a wonderful day. We love you. God bless you. Thank you for all that you do. Amen. Amen. You are dismissed.